Josh from Active Tours, and today we're in Maui. Over the years, I've been to most of the Hawaiian Islands, but my heart belongs to Maui. As they say, Maui no ke oi. Maui is the best. On this last trip, I compiled a list of the best things to do in Maui. Apologies for my mispronunciation of the Hawaiian words. Much love and respect to the Hawaiian people. Number 1, the Road to Hana. Now, the Road to Hana is an epic choose-your-own-adventure road trip to some of the best attractions on Maui. With about 64 miles, 620 curves, and 59 bridges, it's probably the windiest of roads you'll ever drive, and you'll want to take your time doing it. If you choose to do this in one day, you're going to want to wake up very early to see the most things or to spend a little bit more time at your favorite places along the way. I really recommend that you spend a night in the town of Hana so that you're able to take your time and visit some of the best spots with little to no one else around. I have an extensive video on the top 20 places to visit on the road to Hana, so take a look for that video, link in the description below. I do recommend that if you do get motion sickness, you're probably going to want to take something for the drive. We'll talk a little bit more about my favorite places on the road to Hana a little bit later in this video. Number 2, Haleakala for sunrise or for sunset. Looming high over Maui is the dormant volcano Haleakala, meaning house of the sun. Now, legend goes that the demigod Maui lassoed the sun from its journey across the sky as he stood on top of the volcano's summit, slowing its descent and making the day last longer. Now, visiting the summit of the volcano at sunrise or sunset is a spiritual experience that you cannot miss. You have to jump through some hoops to summit this 10,023-foot volcano for sunrise, as it's very popular and you need to make a reservation a week in advance and wake up super early, and even then you might not have any luck. Like on my recent visit, all I saw was clouds and rain. Of course, you're going to want to bring the appropriate gear for this trip. I also drove up again for sunset later in my trip, as it was well worth the extra drive. In addition, for sunset you can tell what the clouds are doing before you head up the mountain, which is an added benefit of waiting for sunset. Regardless, I recommend you watching the sun crest or disappear over the horizon, and on a clear day you can see the Big Islands mountains from here as well. I'll put a link in the description of the top things to do on the Big Island. Number 3, the Pipiwai Trail. Although technically past the town of Hana, this is often the last stop people make on the road to Hana before they turn around. It's absolutely the highlight of my journey on this road, and you're going to want to make sure you get to the trailhead fairly early, as the park ranger is telling people that the park closes right at the trailhead. I recommend getting here at least by 3 p.m., and since it's part of Haleakala National Park, you should try to time this visit with the 3-day pass that you get at the top of Haleakala. You can hit both destinations for the $30 entrance fee. This is a 3.4-mile round-trip hike that highlights a bamboo forest, a huge sprawling banyan tree, a number of smaller waterfalls, and the crown jewel of the whole trail, the Waimuku Falls. This trail is not to be missed. If you do stay in the town of Hana, this would be a fantastic hike to do first thing in the morning, as you'll likely be alone on the trail. Number 4, snorkeling with turtles. Now, most people think of Hawaii and they think of sunshine and beaches, and maybe third on that list is sea turtles. Maui is loaded with a bunch of spots that are amazing for seeing the beautiful coral reef, tropical fish, and sea turtles. During my recent solo trip, I spent a lot of time snorkeling and found some amazing spots. I'm going to put a full list of the top snorkeling spots in Maui in the description below, but by far my favorite spot for finding sea turtles was Honolua Bay, which means two harbors. It was really special to float in the water and watch these chill creatures and going about their business. I must have seen 5+ turtles within the hour that I was swimming around. Now, green sea turtles can grow up to 350 pounds, and I saw a huge one that I'll show you a little bit later in this video. Remember to keep your distance from the honu and wear reef-safe sunscreen. We want our children's children to enjoy these reefs as well. Number 5, the Sliding Sands Trail. There are some trails that you just never forget, and hiking into the Haleakala Crater is just one of those awe-inspiring hikes that will have you dreaming that you're on the surface of Mars. This trail starts at the top of Haleakala, and then the 11-mile hike takes you clear across the crater. If you don't get a pickup, you'll have to come all the way back up the same way you came. Even if you do a few miles of the hike and turn around, it'll be well worth the effort, as you can descend the 2,500 feet to the crater floor in just 3.9 miles. It's one of the most unique landscapes that you'll ever see. I recommend doing this hike a few hours before sunset and timing the end of the hike to see the sun dip below the horizon at the summit. Number 6, eat the local food. Now, I've heard a few people on my trip say that they don't like Hawaiian food, and I really just don't understand. If you're looking for Japanese, Chinese, Mexican, go to Japan, China, or Mexico. Hawaii is 1,860 miles from the nearest continent. Its food is a unique mixture of local food and culinary takes from other countries, with an aloha vibe. Granted, if you're a vegetarian or a vegan, you might only be eating tropical fruit, rice, and seaweed, so that might be an issue. But guys, the fish is legendary, and the local food like the kalua pork, lau lau, lomi salmon, spam musubi are some of the smells that tell me to slow down that I'm in Hawaii. And get some of that shave ice at Ulani's and relax on the beach. I recommend you get the sunset flavoring and go with the ice cream and mochi. I have a full video on the food that I ate on this trip coming out, so hit that subscribe button to be notified once that one drops. It's gonna be tasty. Number 7, whale watching. In the winter months, December through May, the whales travel 5,000 miles from their feeding grounds in Alaska and Russia to their breeding and nursery grounds in Hawaii. I went with a small raft tour from Captain Steve's and I had a fantastic time. It was early in the humpback whale season and we got lucky to see the closest whale breach Captain Steve had seen all season. Did you know that humpback whales can grow up to 52 feet long and weigh 30 tons? The reason why whales like to visit here is because the islands here provide the whales with Hawaii's deep, warm ocean, and underwater visibility that's next level, and a lack of natural predators. Even if it's not whale season, I recommend going and taking a boat ride. It's amazing to think about the first explorers to these islands and how absolutely nuts they were to have faith that something was out there. Number 8, Wai Napa Napa State Park. Now, Wai Napa Napa means glistening water, and the state park is one of the main highlights on the road to Hana. The black sand beach at Wai Napa Napa State Park is mesmerizing, but don't let that fully distract you from the other features that make this state park amazing. Now, just at the bottom of the black sand beach is a small lava cave that is gorgeous and small and hidden enough that you can probably have a moment or two inside the cave all to yourself. On the other side of the beach is a trail where you can explore the lava-filled coastline around the surrounding cliffs. You can see a number of different sea arches, and there is even a freshwater cave that once upon a time a Hawaiian princess was murdered in. Number 9, scuba diving. Now, scuba diving in the warm Hawaiian waters is one of my favorite activities. I booked a trip with the Maui Diving Company to dive Molokini Crater, but the weather wasn't on my side for this trip. In the winter, the weather can get a little unpredictable, so we headed to the leeward side of the island to do some diving south of Lahaina. It's always a mystery what you're gonna see on a dive. On this one, we saw maybe a 300-pound sea turtle, a giant starfish, fish, some cool sponge crabs, and I found my favorite sea creature, octopus. Now look how amazing these guys are. Super smart. Now, I highly recommend going diving here even if you haven't gone before. You can do a discovery dive and you'll have lots of fun. It's the closest thing to flying on a different world that you ever get, unless Elon sends me to Mars. There'll be a link in the description if I ever go to space. Number 10, Makena Beach, Big Beach. Now, one of Maui's signature beaches is Makena Beach. It stretches almost a mile long and is one of Maui's largest undeveloped beaches. Makena also offers protection from the trade winds and provides great views of the islands of Molokini and Kiho'ulawe. I saw a ton of locals on this beach bodyboarding, and there are two parking lots, but if they're both full, keep driving south and you'll see some parking on the side of the road. North of Big Beach is Little Beach, which is a clothing optional beach. Number 11, Eyal Valley State Park. Now, this lush 4,000-acre park has lots of hiking, sightseeing, and a nature center. I recommend heading up the trail to the famous 1,200-foot Eyal Needle to take in the amazing views of the rainforest. This sacred Eyal Valley has great historical significance and is where King Kamehameha I clashed with Maui's armies in his quest to unite all of the islands. There are a few secret hikes that start from this area as well. Just be sure to be respectful as you head down one of those trails. More on that trail in a future video. Number 12, the Waihe'e Ridge Trail. Now, the steep ridgeline hikes are what Hawaii is all about, and this one has epic views of the windward side of Maui and beyond. The trail is 3.9 miles out and back, with 1,574 feet of elevation gain. That definitely makes for a rewarding hike. Remember, a lot of the hikes in Hawaii are really muddy, so be sure to bring the appropriate gear with you. There is a link in the description on how I pack for an active trip to Hawaii. When you get to the summit, you may not see much because often the hike leads you into the clouds. I recommend hiking the trail anyway. It's all about the experience. Even if you get a little wet, it's all about the adventure. I also want to take time to talk about Rapid Ohia Death. Ohia is a sacred tree that's endemic to Hawaii, and there's a fungus and could be tracked on your shoes. So show a little aloha and clean your shoes before and after any hikes. Mahalo. Number 13, Ka'anapali Beach and Black Rock. Now, with 3 miles of white sand and crystal clear water, there's no wonder Ka'anapali Beach was once named America's best beach. Black Rock is a lava outcropping that's on the north side of Ka'anapali Beach, and I've seen sea turtles here. It's loads of fun to go cliff jumping off the huge rock, and held every evening at sunset, a cliff diver lights torches along the cliff and dives in from Black Rock in a reenactment of a feat by Maui. My friend Annie does it way better. Number 14, ride a bike down Haleakala. Now, the volcano of Haleakala sits at 10,023 feet, and one of the most epic ways to head back down to sea level is by bike. You can rent bikes from a couple of vendors in Maui, and they can either drop you off and ride your own way back to the shop, or you can take a tour with them. I should note that they start you about halfway down the volcano, but it's still an amazing ride and something that I would highly recommend you do if you have time for it. Number 15, the King's Highway. I love this hike. It feels like being on another planet. The trail is on the leeward side of Maui and is home to the freshest lava flow in 1790 on the island, in La Perouse Bay. That, in conjunction with being on the dry side of the island, means there's not much else that's here other than lava rock. Hundreds of years earlier, the path was the King's Trail and circled much of the island. The trail takes you through archaeological sites dating back hundreds and hundreds of years, so please do not touch anything along the trail. The hike is pretty flat, but you are walking on loose lava rock here, which makes for some uneasy footing at times. And remember to bring lots of water and a good hat with you. Number 16, explore a lava tube. Now, if you've never explored a lava tube, I highly recommend it. They're amazing wonders that are left behind from some of nature's most creative and destructive forces. There's quite a few of them on the Big Island, but here on Maui, I only know of this one large lava tube that you can explore. I paid a few dollars and headed down this tube, and since I was a solo person, they gave me 2 flashlights just in case one went out. That's kind of scary. I explored the stalactites and stalagmites, and I was able to see the lava flow line that was left behind. It was a fairly quick stop on the road to Hana, but I highly recommend exploring one if you get the chance. If you don't have time here, there's a small one at Wainapanapa State Park that you should definitely see. Number 17, Twin Falls. Now, Twin Falls is likely the first stop on your journey on the road to Hana. The falls are on private land, but the owners allow you to explore the falls and the land anyway. Mahalo nui loa. I think most of the people stop and take a look at the first falls only, but I recommend you take the extra hike and look at the magnificent Twin Falls. The hike is very easy and you do have one stream crossing, but it makes for great fun. Just be sure to watch out for any flash flooding that might be happening upstream. If you get there really early, I expect you to be the only ones at the falls, so enjoy. Remember to provide donations or buy some banana bread at the stand in support of the landowners. Number 18, the Wioka Pond, aka the Venus Pools. Wow, this place is amazing. It was the last stop on my way back from the road to Hana, and I was super happy that I stopped here. There was a local doing some crazy cliff jumps off the rocks here. It was amazing to watch. Next time I visit, I'll definitely be spending more time here relaxing in the pool. Wioka's meaning is said to be derived from another Hawaiian word that means open mouth to fresh water. Number 19, the Lahaina Pali Trail. This 4.3 mile, nearly 1600 feet of elevation gain is a fantastic hike for sunset. If you have time, you can start hiking down as the sun is setting, and you can bask in that sunset light all the way down. The hike is on the leeward side of the island, so it's usually dry, and if you're seeing a rainy day in the forecast, this hike might just be the ticket. You also climb up to this huge wind farm, and they have fantastic views of Haleakala, Kihei, and far beyond that. Number 20, Nakalele Blowhole. The Nakalele Blowhole is one of the highlights in the West Maui road trip, and I recommend going around the entire loop of West Maui. There's a small dirt parking lot, and then you have to scramble down a trail and some rocks to the blowhole. I recommend that you head down the trail. And don't worry about the lookout. You can get plenty of good views of the blowhole on your way down. You'll want to stay clear from the hole as people have been sucked into the hole to their death. It's always important to respect the lands that you walk on. Aloha, Aina. I also recommend that you stop by a little coconut stand that's in the parking lot. There's nothing better than a fresh coconut, and buying them directly from the locals means that you're giving back directly to the Hawaiian people. Okay, guys, that was my list. It was an epic, huge list. If you liked it, hit that subscribe button, hit the thumbs up, and comment below. Let me know what your favorite thing is in Maui. I would love to hear back from you guys. In future videos, I have Molokai videos, videos in Oahu, all kinds of videos that I'm going to continue to spit out from Maui as well. It's going to be a lot of content. So please hit that subscribe button. Thank you very much. Aloha, and mahalo.